Hi, I'm Brett Evans with MotorOne.com, and today I am hanging out with this beauty. This is the Nissan Z Proto, which previews the next generation Z car, which should arrive either next year or the year after. It combines a lot of the things that we love about the current Z car: powerful engine, available manual transmission, stiff rear-wheel drive architecture, and at the same time, look at it. From the 240Z-inspired front end to the 300ZX-inspired tail, the Z Proto might as well be a greatest hits album of the coolest Nissan sports cars of the past. We can't wait to see this thing out on the road, but for now, let's take a closer look. Let's start with the front end. There's a really beautiful three-dimensional hood bulge that resolves into a really sharp and crisp point on the front bumper in the hood. And underneath that is a really big, gaping hood opening that actually looks much more dynamic and interesting the closer you get. As you can see, there's some depth to it with kind of a forward-leaning design, and there's these really beautiful rounded rectangles that appear elsewhere on the car. And then, of course, there's the revised Nissan logo, which pairs up with the Z logo that makes a return from the past. The more you look at the Z, the more details reveal themselves to you. For example, right here on this side scuttle, there's a really cool triple Z effect going on. One that starts on the hood and kind of devolves into the side scuttle, another one that goes from the scuttle to the door mirror, and then a sideways Z that incorporates the door shut line. Other interesting details, there's this vertical, you know, door handle that is cribbed straight off of the 350Z and the 370Z. One of the other details they pointed out was this katana side blade. Now, in addition to being a very modern styling feature that kind of avoids that floating roof trend that's been going on for a couple years now, it also sort of recalls the rain gutter on an original Z car. It's a pretty sleek and subtle nod to history without necessarily being this big fat retro pastiche. It's pretty cool. The same thing about this black painted roof, which sort of recalls the T-tops of the 300ZX and earlier Z cars. Hopefully that means they'll make it an option on this new model, but we probably shouldn't hold our breath for that one. There's also a lot to love about the Z Proto when viewed from behind as well. This beautiful full-width blackout panel might as well be a shot-for-shot remake of the 300ZX. And they also snuck a Fair Lady Z badge onto the rear deck. That's a really cool callback to what the vehicle was called in global markets before being renamed 240Z here. It's really nice to see this retro-inspired Z logo make a return to the Z Proto. This shouldn't have ever left the sports car brand, but I'm glad that it's back. Let's talk about the hardware that's going to show up under this machine's shapely skin when it arrives sometime in the next couple of years. Hiding behind these beautiful bronze-painted wheels is a very serious-looking brake package, with some yellow brake calipers that definitely call attention to themselves. And it looks like Nissan took some care to handle the aerodynamics of this machine as well, with some very beautiful carbon fiber ground effects on the side. That carbon fiber also shows up on the rear in this really attractive, very sleek diffuser that hides these beautiful twin outlet exhausts. This looks for all the world like the same diffuser in the DBX that I drove a couple of weeks ago, which is high praise for Nissan. Stepping inside the Nissan Z Proto, it's apparent that designers went to great lengths to distinguish this cabin from that of the 370Z. Now, I've got a sneaking suspicion that this is actually a 370Z cabin dressed up with new materials and a new design, but I'm not going to complain about that because they've done a very, very good job with it. There are a lot of pretty interesting modern cues, like these rounded rectangle HVAC vents, the same shape that you'll see recalled in the taillights and the grille, and then a very interesting heritage design in this triple gauge cluster atop the dashboard. Just about every Z car that I can think of has had a similar auxiliary gauge package. It's complemented with a modern 21st century fully digital instrument cluster, and of course, there's this beautiful manual transmission. A 6-speed manual will be standard, and an automatic should be optional. We know that the Z car is going to be powered by a twin turbo V6 engine, probably the 4-liter found in the Infiniti Q50 Red Sport, where it makes more than 400 horsepower. The next generation Nissan Z probably won't arrive for another year or two, but when it does, it looks like it's going to be worth the wait. This gorgeous styling is just the tip of the iceberg for what is going to make this a very special sports car. Nissan should be proud of this machine, and we cannot wait to slip behind the wheel.